Today I'm going to be covering Wrike plus the Adobe Creative Cloud native integration. My name is Ryan Candela. I'm a senior sales engineer with Wrike and looking forward to showing this to you. So talking a little bit about what it is at first. Okay, so Wrike developed an extension that can be installed with the Adobe Creative Cloud products. Currently it can be installed with Photoshop, InDesign, Illustrator, and Premiere Pro. What's great about this is it's going to add a plugin into those apps so that your creators can stay within their native applications without having to bounce back and forth between Wrike to Photoshop and, you know, having to do proofing in between the two. They'll be able to stay within that software and work 100% from within there while also updating your management team and all your tasks within Wrike. So let's dive in a little bit. How does that work? Well, first they need to install that extension, and they can do that by visiting exchange.adobe.com. Once they're on the exchange, they can just search for Wrike and install this, and it'll install across all the Creative Cloud plugins. Now, with that said, they will need a Wrike account, and so once they're in that plugin, they log in, and that'll tie them straight into their Wrike instance. I'm gonna hop over to Photoshop real quick and show you that what it kind of looks like. So here's what it looks like with zero tasks whatsoever. On the right-hand side, I have this panel open for Wrike. This is my to-do list. I don't have anything. So let's go ahead and dive in. I'm gonna go ahead and jump in straight into Wrike as if we were a manager and we wanted to delegate some of that work to one of our creators. So back to my web browser, I hop into Wrike. I've got this project, it's a 2022 website overhaul. So we're getting ready to do a whole new website. And one of those tasks that we have is creating a new hero image for the homepage. So I'm gonna click on that task. I just created it, so there's really nothing in there. So I'm gonna go ahead and say, you know, hey there, would love to have these attachments combined for a new hero image for our website. Thanks. So we can throw some stuff in the description. I can come over here and grab a couple of those assets. So of course, we're probably gonna want to have a background. We're also gonna wanna have a logo. Just drag and drop those things on here. And then I'm just gonna say ready to fly, right? And so we can do comments. You can see I'm doing a couple of things here. I'm adding some comments, I'm adding a description, I'm adding some assets. I'm also gonna go ahead and set a due date because, you know, within Wrike, we love calendaring our items. Now from here, there's still nothing going on over in Adobe Photoshop. What triggers that event is me actually assigning that to my designer. So right there, I just shared that task with my designer. They're gonna get a multitude of notifications depending on how they're set up, right? If they have the mobile app, they'll get a notification there. If they have Wrike, they'll get a ping up in the corner. And if they have their settings set this way, they'll also get an email letting them know that that exists. At which point, they can just dive straight into Adobe Photoshop. Now, if they're already in Photoshop, they will real time, live, see that task pop up as you see here. Just a quick little intro, all I'd have to do is click on this little arrow to just bring it down and see everything that has to go with that project or that task. I have a little blue highlight over here, which tells me the status that the project is in. And I can also click on comments and see all those comments, just like the ready to fly from a minute ago. And see the description that was put in there, or I can close this back and take a look at these graphics. So I read what I'm supposed to do right here natively in Photoshop. I'm just going to download and open both of those files, and it brings them straight in. I'm going to take that logo, drag and drop it over to that, you know, that backdrop that they had, and throw it in the middle, and I say, hey, this looks great. Let's go ahead and save that out. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hit add that to, as a task, or add it to the task as a new file. It is going to have me go ahead and save this locally, and the reason why it does that is just so that it has, you know, some time to render and push up to Wrike. So I've got my local copy here. Boom. Just like that, within a matter of seconds, if we hop back over to Wrike, my manager can now see that file that I just created. One of the great things about this takes the management team straight into the proofing module that's built into Wrike. And I won't go into the full depths on how the proofing module works. There's tons of resources online, and we'll just keep this kind of Adobe related, but I do want to show you how interactive this can be between a manager and your creator back in Photoshop. So let's say as the manager, I take a look at this first rendition and I like it, but you know, I want to just click here and just say, love it so far. Could we make the logo bigger? And happy to throw a smiley face in there. Let them know that they're on the right track, okay? So this looks great. I'm gonna pause here and just jump straight back in over here and go to that comments section. And you can see just like that, real time, live, I've got these comments, I've got these requests, okay? And maybe my manager would even change that status over from new to change request or something like that so I can stack rank these. So you know what? That's a super easy request. I'm gonna go ahead and take the logo. We'll drag it over here. We're gonna make it bigger. And you know, let's see if they like us putting the logo up top too. Love it, everything looks great. I'm gonna go ahead and hit back. And then I'm gonna hit update on that same file. Same thing as last time, we were gonna create that local copy just so it can render up to the cloud and rasterize down to a PNG or a JPEG. Hopping right back over into Wrike, you see that I've already been given a live action notice. Hey, this file's been updated. Would you wanna see the latest version? So we could click yes, or we can actually click up here and I can see both of these versions. I could do a side-by-side of both of these versions, which is great. Or my personal favorite, I can actually overlay these versions. And so as I drag from version 1 to version 2, I can make some decisions there. So as the manager, I love decision 2. I'm gonna exit that comparison. And then what I'm gonna do is close down and I can actually select this for an approval. Once it's selected for an approval, that content creator can come in on their end, or the manager can come in on their end, and they can simply come in and change that status to completed, marking that task in real time over here in Wrike as completed. So I hope this gives you kind of a brief glimpse into, you know, the power of the native integrations that we have with the Adobe Creative Cloud product and how you can effectively use it with your team while keeping your content creators, you know, keep them doing what they do best, and if for more efficiency, keep them within Photoshop. Don't make them go back and forth to Wrike.